Good to see you, partner.
It's great to see you. You know, I know you're a good old Texas boy, and you were inducted into the Texas Songwriters Hall of Fame.
Isn't that something?
Well, it is. It's quite an achievement. How'd you get from Texas to Nashville?
My cousin, Robert Earl Keene, and his roommate in college, Lyle Lovett, had come up here and were hanging around Guy Clark and Rodney Crowell and that bunch. And it just seemed to me like the doors in Texas were just closing, you know. And the window, there was a little window up here in Nashville opening up. And sure enough, about 5 months, 2 week mark, I signed with Polygram Publishing, and I was a staff writer there for 12 years. And that's when I met you, my friend.
Well, I'm sure glad you did, because you were an important part of one of my recordings, as we have just showed the folks earlier in this show. You were on Arista Records back when Tim Dubois was there. Now, how did you get on that label? How did you make that deal?
I'd been at Polygram for about 6 months. I was writing every day, and we had a nice little studio down there at the in the bottom of the building there. Nice. My demos became my records down there, and Tim kept sticking his head in and going, keep it up, keep it up. Sure enough, he said, we're going to do this thing, and Barry Beckett and I went into the studio, and thank God for Barry Beckett.
Man. Well, you had a great producer there.
Yeah.
How old were you when you started playing, though, the guitar?
I was, well, let's see. Dad showed me how to play Milk Cow Blues when I was probably about 8 or 9.
But now you have a Gibson guitar named for you. How
yes,
about
sir.
That, folks?
Yes, sir.
You don't get a guitar named for you from a big guitar company that easy, and that's saying quite a bit, Leroy.
Thank you. I was very honored, and it's really kind of unbelievable still. But
Merle Haggard is a favorite of mine, and he wrote a song that you had a hit on with Diamond Rio and Steve Warner. Right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. We actually got. I think we got a CMA nomination for that, and got to be on. Stage when Merle got inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame. And that was a real kick because I loved Merle too.
You know, I'd sure like to try that Merle Haggard song if you're up for it.
Oh, shoot, yeah, I'd love to. Yeah, man.
Let's do it.
All right.
All right.
Yeah.
It's a big job getting by for 9 kids and a wife. I've been a working man, dang near all my life, and I keep on working. Long as my two hands fit to you. Drink a little beer in the tavern, sing a little bit of them working man blues.
Well, I keep my nose to the grindstone, work hard every day. Get a little tired on the weekend after I draw my pay, but I just go on back working. Come Monday morning, I'm back with the crew.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. Drink a little beer that evening, sing a little bit of working man blues.
A working man like me. I've never been on welfare, and that's one place I'm gonna be, cause I'll be working.
Oh,
my new brand new pair of shoes, that's all it'll do. Drank a little beer every evening, got a little bit of these working man.
Am I playing?
I believe so.
Oh, fit to you. Drank a little beer in the tavern, tried a little bit of these working man blues.
Alright,
yeah, drank a little beer in the tavern, sang a little bit of these working man blues. That's all a little bit. How about that?
Leroy Parnell, ladies and gentlemen.